Sri Tapan Sen.
Thank you, Deputy Chairman, sir. At the outset, I pray your indulgence so that I can put forth my points in full. Secondly, at the outset, while responding on this finance bill and the budgetary exercise, I like to express my full agreement with my friend, Mr. Subbirami Reddy ji Haini here, that you are following, rather photocopying their policy. My second expression of agreement with my brother here, Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi, who told that they have inherited an economy in utter distress, in a bad situation. I want to synthesize these two agreements of mine with both the sides and like to say that in real sense, your budgetary exercise and the finance bill of the new government reflect a faithful continuity of its older counterpart, the previous UP2 regime, which actually has landed the country, the economy, in this present morose and distress. But still you prefer to follow the same trajectory, photocopy the same route, lamenting that the economy is in a bad shape. I urge upon the government to please reflect upon this aspect particularly. Sir, Honorable Finance Minister, while replying to the budget speech, told that my budget is one of a very low tax regime. My point is, low tax regime for whom? For 3% of populace who are paying direct tax. For them, definitely. You have foregone 22,220 crores on direct tax. Yes, some you have lowered their burden. But what about the others? त्यागी जी बोला जो एक दुनिया और भी है जो आसमान में छूटता नहीं है वो सिर्फ डायरेक्ट टैक्स देते हैं और उसका बर्डन यू हैव इंक्रीज मैनीफोल्ड यू हैव क्लेम टू हैव गेन इंक्रीज द इनडायरेक्ट टैक्स बर्डन बाय 7,525 करोड़ बट द मैनर यू हैव गिवन वाइड कॉन्सेशन ऑन कस्टम्स ड्यूटीज एंड इम्पोर्ट इफ इट इज टेकन नेट ऑफ दैट What is the exact impact on excise duty burden on the people? It must be much more than 7,525 crore. And I urge the finance minister, please come out with a specific figure. Net of your exemptions on customs and import duty, what is your extra gain on the indirect tax account? In your budget estimate compared to revised estimate last year, you have estimated an indirect tax gain of 27,520 crores. It is not 7,525 crores. For whom the low tax regime, Mr. Finance Minister? Sir, when you talk like this, what is the share of direct tax? It is consistently declining on the total gross revenue. I am not blaming you because you have just taken over the state of economy. But what is the context? What is the background on which you have taken over the economy? What is the trend? The trend is that the share of direct tax in the gross tax revenue is declining consistently. And it has a deliberate pattern which has evolved. It was somewhere in 54.99% in 2008-09. It was 55.16% in 2008-09. It came to 54.9% in 13-14, and in your budget estimate, it has drawn further 1% less. It is 53.1. What is your preference? Consequently, complementarily, the burden of indirect tax is going up, and still you are claiming that it's a low tax regime. How can you justify this statement of yours? And this is happening when the Indian economy is facing a kind of income disparity and inequality to a very obscene extent. No civilized society should put up with such wide income inequality and disparity, where 100 topmost rich of our 120 crore population have garnered the grip over more than 25% of our GDP, while 77% of population, 84 crore people, are living a beastly life with below 20 rupees per day. Is that a very ideal situation when you will be declining the, reducing the share of direct tax rate on the total tax revenue and pushing up the indirect tax rate? Is it a, you are doing it aggravating the thing. Many people do not count about the burden of indirect tax on the poorest of the poor. There was a study by an Hyderabad-based research group, and that study says that the rickshawwalas, rack pickers, having an average income of 3,300 per month, are facing an indirect tax burden of 10.6% of their income. That is 330 rupees more, earning a 3,300 rupees a month. Please go through. Is that a real situation you are want to we are wanting to create? And on the other hand, you are taking steps one by after step by severely cutting the subsidy on the common people. You are also planning in the same way. Your previous government has taken a target, 1.75% of the GDP, they will bring down the subsidy on common people while giving away 5%. Just now, Mr. Ram Gopal Jadavji has told, 5% on your giveaways through direct tax concessions. You are targeting 1.75% of the GDP. It was the UPA 2 government's target. What is your target? Please come out. You have set up an expenditure management, management commission to make the subsidy more targeted. What is your target of reduction? Please come out. Or if there is no target for reduction, please also tell the house. Already you have reduced in the petroleum the subsidy burden to the tune of 22,000 crore, having a cascading impact on already existing inflationary rate. And while the people, subsidy on people is being reduced, subsidy on the 1.5% of the people, what you are giving in the name of so-called incentives, I will not say about the tax foregone. Already Ram Gopal ji has said, and our Arun Jaitley ji has given a logic on it, that we have reduced on senior citizens, we have reduced burden on the income tax for salaried person. I admit, I welcome those salaried, the relief you have given on the salaried person. Plus, madam, please give us a disaggregated figure. Out of that 22,000 crore direct tax, you have reduced, burden you have reduced. What is the share of that wage earners whom you have given relief? What is the share of the senior citizen whom you have given relief? And what is the share of those who are pilfering the national exchequer by deliberate tax default and who are also pilfering the public money in the banks by creating NPA to the tune of 2 lakh crore? How much is their share out of your 22,000 crore direct tax relief? Please come out. That is also a subsidy to an 1.5% of the populace at the cost of 99% of the population. And what is the figures today? It is a pattern has been developed, consistently increasing. After all your concessions, whatever tax is realized that is not being collected. I understand there are certain weakness, deficiencies in your tax management system. For 1 year, for 2 years, but consistently it is developing, it is continuing. It is continuing. Direct tax default, which was around 77,000 crore 10 years back, which has gone up to 4.86 lakh crore on the current year, as per your own budget statement. As per your own budget statement, it has gone up to that level. How do you say? What do you suggest out of that? It was 77,000 crore in 2005-06. It reached to 1.86 lakh crore in 2009-10, a 135% increase. And from thereafter, in 12-13, it reached 86 lakh crore, a 170% increase. So it is just not your systemic deficiency. It is a pattern deliberately promoted year after year. And that is all about this neoliberal economic paradigm, where this 1% for them त्यागी जी का भाषा में जो चंदा देता है, यू आर सो ओवरपावर्ड फॉर देम, यू फॉरगेट द रेस्ट हु आर क्रिएटिंग योर जीडीपी, डिलीवरिंग मनी टू योर एक्सचेकर एंड अदर ग्रुप फॉर हुम यू आर डूइंग, दे आर पिलफरिंग द नेशनल एक्सचेकर. दिस 48.6 lakh crore is a pilferage, patronized pilferage by the corporate houses, and you are promoting them. It is they who are pilfering money, public money from the banking system, and you are promoting them, you are indulging them. It is no question that you make burden lower, there will be better compliance. Please go through the latest CAG report. The voluntary compliance part of your tax, that percentage is going down noticeably. Please go through it. By giving concession, you cannot change the heart of a thief. And that theft is going on in public exchequer. Your finance bill must have targeted this team of, this community of pilferers. And that is would have been a great service to the nation. And a country, a government, having expressed so much concern about your fiscal deficit, so much concern, cutting down the stomach of the common people by reducing your subsidy, remain thoroughly unconcerned, rather indulgent, rather patronizing this deliberate tax pilferage in the public exchequer. I can't, I am not blaming you, madam, or this government, because you have just taken over. My point is that this whole economic policy paradigm, you are following the same trajectory. Will you continue with the same patronization to this deliberate pilferer of the public exchequer? If not, what is your program? Sir, it is not that your income tax system has gone or direct tax system has gone something wrong and you are not being able to do it. What is the system? It is year after year, it has been, pattern has been sent. A pattern of policy has been devised and you are photocopying this. How can you bring good days for the people unless you change your policy trajectory? If you photocopy the same, we will be destined to further distress and danger. Let me tell you, I don't want the country to fall in danger, and so I want you to change your policy trajectory. Please, sir, sometime. Sir, madam, I have got some concrete suggestions on the matter of policy matter. Previous government again. I have to defer because you are debate, this is your debate budget. They made out a, brought a proposal, expressed concern about the tax evasion, and brought a proposal of general anti-evidence rule. It was brought in the budget, and I remember in my budget speech I told you welcome that. But when passing the budget, shockingly, finance minister announced that we are deferring it for 1 year. Immediately thereafter, they appointed a committee by Parthasarathy Som. The day he was appointed, on the third day itself, he made a statement in the budget that these are all bogus. No GAAR and no retrospective. Everything tailored and tutored. That was the pattern they have followed. Are you following the same pattern? If not, if you are really concerned about the black money generation in the economy, a major part of which is coming from the illegitimate tax evasion, you have to bring back GAAR. I am shocked when finance minister, while presenting the speech, made his obsessed statement, no, we are not going to, say, bring retrospective taxation, etc., etc. Sir or madam, whom we are following, that year it was introduced on the same year, same tax was introduced by the British government with 27 years retrospective. In our case, we have an offender in front of our eyes, those companies, merger through merger and acquisition. I don't like to take their name. And we propose for a 7 years retrospective. Our conscience doesn't prick us. When we see that exchequer is being pilfered in this manner, we introduce a proposal, I'm going back. I request this government, please reconsider, bring back GAAR if you are really serious about black money, containing black money. If you are really serious about black money, please impose a serious regulatory control on the double taxation avoidance treaty, which creates a situation that black money generated in our country, repatriated abroad, getting recycled through those tax havens in our country as FDI. Oh, great FDI. 44% of the FDI flowing to our country is coming from Mauritius, and only 7% from USA, great USA. How can you? It is an open daylight discrepancy and inconsistency, and we are comfortable in sleeping with it, managing with it, carrying with it. And we tell that we create an economy free of black money. So these are the issues which please seriously consider. Very quick, 1 or 2 minutes, I'm concluding. Sir, I concretely suggest your indirect tax burden, 40% comes from petroleum product. And the people are heavily burdened on it. It is your own budget statement says. I suggest the private sector standalone refineries who are exporting their entire product, the public sector oil marketing companies are catering to domestic need at a moderated price at the instance of the government. And private sector standalone refineries are exporting their almost entire product and earning a huge profit riding on the wave of the rising price of the petroleum in the international market. Why don't you put a windfall tax after the level of their export earning? They are using our resources. They also use the oil explored by us in the country. They are also getting their share. Why don't you put an windfall tax? And this is nothing new that India is going to do. Some of the European Western countries, they have resorted to this taxation. Why should you not do it? Why should you not consider? And at the end, to check the tax default. If the economic regime is the present process of a reverse transfer from the millions to the handful, this perverse
needs
to be resisted. I'm coming.
Please conclude.
I'm coming. Why don't you bring all taxpayer at par? The poor taxpayer, a worker in the factory or an employee in an office, are meant to pay their tax claim first and then demand the refund. Why don't you make the other taxpayers on the same, whatever claim has been lodged by the tax department, they must pay it first and then go to court? You are talking about litigation. Let me tell you, it is your own figure. Out of 4.86 lakh crore, 2,091 crore is a tax default not under any dispute, but lying uncollected for the last 3 to 10 years. Your own paper says. And that figure also not only on the last year figure. There also a pattern has been set. It was earlier 30,000 crore. Then it increased, consistently increased. Last year and this year's difference, the unrealized tax, direct tax, not under any dispute, it increased by 40% from 51,330 crores to 72,000 crores.
Now, Mr. Sabha,
why you are not collecting this?
Sabha, please.
So, please. I want to say, please, I'm concluding just one sentence. Please do away with this perversion in your economic management. This perversion has been cultivated over years in the name of neoliberal economic philosophy, which is expected to bring change in the economy in 46 days, as my Subiram Reddy has claimed. I'm telling you that it is not possible. Please change the trajectory.
Okay.
Please change the, refrain yourself from this perverse economic policy route. With this, I thank you to please reconsider my suggestion. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much.